Now, should private hospitals be blamed for the delay in the release of benefits to its health workers? Joining us now for our second hot copy, Dr. Jose Rene De Grano, President of Private Hospitals Association of the Philippines. Dr. De Grano, good morning, sir.
Good morning, Karen, and to all our viewers out there.
All right. I want to ask you, of the private hospitals under the PHAP, how many have actually received and not received any kind of benefits coming from the government under Bayanihan 2?
Actually, we do not have the actual number, no? But we estimate at least around 50% have not received. Some have not received the first tranche, and then the others have not received the second tranche.
Would it be right to say, Dr. Grano, the calculation or per medical frontliner is around 38,000 pesos? Would that be the right number for you?
Yes, more or less around 30 plus, because that will amount to around 5,000 per month. And okay, that started December, no? December up to June 30. So more or less it's 38,000.
All right. And Secretary Duque said, frankly, it's the fault of the private hospitals. Because ang sabi niya, ang mga pribadong ospital ang may kilala ng mga tao nila na dapat tumanggap, at sila daw dapat ang in effect, no, nagsusumite ng mga pangalang yon. So it should be the private hospitals, the owners, the management, asking for these benefits, submitting the names to the DOH. What is the reality?
Yes,
on the ground?
Yes, yung second statement niya, totoo yun, no, Karen, because responsibility yon ng mga different private hospitals. But then what he said, na the fund is already in the hospitals, and it is the hospital that is keeping the SRA from the healthcare workers. That's not true.
Because so that's a lie.
Yeah, because we asked our members when he told that in the news media. We asked all our members. Some in the north were able to get already the second tranche, but the rest of the country, especially region 3, region 4, even Batangas, Laguna, and Quezon, we asked all the hospitals there, and they have not received their SRA. Even some areas in Visayas and some areas in Mindanao, especially region 12, they have not received the SRA.
Mm-mm.
Yes.
Mm-mm. So, for example, in Metro Manila, let's start with somewhere easy, NCR. Mm-hmm. Have you actually conducted a poll? How many private hospitals in Metro Manila have received their SRA plus for their medical frontliners?
Yes, I think most of the private hospitals have received them, you know. But there are still
but not St. Luke's. I just spoke with a union employee said of St. Luke's, they don't have it.
Yes, I don't know, something probably there is a problem with the disbursement in our region. You know, the problem is probably the Dr. Duque, Secretary Duque, was misinformed by his people, by his subordinates, that these funds were already disbursed, because they have to pass through the region first. Then from the region, they will go to the PIDOHO, or the PIDOHO is the provincial DOH offices, no, provincial offices. And then the provincial offices will disburse this supposedly directly to the hospitals. The problem now in our region is they pass through the local government units. And you know, when local government units receive money from the national government, they have to undergo some kind of board resolution, hearings, before they can disburse the payment. And so that's what happened in our area. It's taking us more than 3 weeks before we can receive the SRA. Until now, we have not received it.
Can you give me a little background? What area, where is your area, sir?
We are in Batangas right now.
That's right now. So you are in Batangas now?
Yes. And okay. Even premises in Quezon and Laguna I'm experiencing also this thing.
So like in Batangas, for example, how many private hospitals are there?
More or less around 28 private hospitals in the whole province of Batangas.
Okay, and in Batangas, have you taken a poll of the 28 hospitals? Have all the medical frontliners received their SRA?
No, not any of the 28 hospitals or 29 hospitals have received their.
Not at all?
Yes.
So in the hospital, okay.
Yes, the problem is because of the disbursement. You know, the problem is
where is the money had, now? Where is it?
I think it's the local government units.
It's in the local government. You mean in the mayor's office?
Yes.
Not in the provincial government?
No. They have already, some are still probably in the provincial office or DOH office, but then they will eventually disburse this to the local government units. That's where the delay
would have been. What would have been a faster system for you? What would have been effective?
Dapat kasi from the regional, they call it CHD, Center for Health Development. So from the regional, they should go to the PIDOHO, the Provincial Health Office. And then from there, directly, it should be, the checks should be given to the different private hospitals. Mm-mm. The problem siguro that yung sum for, let's say, for one community, let's say, for
it's okay.
For one community, let's say for one a municipality, and we have, let's say, three or four hospitals, and then they will say, they have government facilities there. Siyempre, pag government facilities, it should pass through the local government unit. So the fund probably was lumped with the other government facilities. That's why everything was have to pass through the LGUs. When in fact, the LGUs have nothing to do with that. It's even in the administrative order and the joint circular that the LGUs have nothing to do with the disbursement of this SRA.
But have they actually confirmed that it's with the LGU? Are you for certain that it's there?
Yes, because just yesterday they just had a hearing, the third hearing. Imagine, that was for the past 3 weeks. It has been with them because every week they conduct a hearing, second, third. They need at least three hearings before the board resolution will be passed. And then because it's already Friday, most probably they will release it next week. Mm-mm. So that's a delay of another.
So the problem here clearly is a systems issue and a management issue coming from the DOH on how they strategize to actually release the funds.
Yes, I think
parang, the guidelines. Parang ayuda. Ang Makati naka GCash, mabilis. Mm-hmm. Ang iba nagdi-distribute pa manually, mabagal. Ganun lang. Right?
Yes. Yeah, the problem is they have different, probably they don't know the real guidelines on how to disperse these funds. So one province will just, directly they will give the check to the private hospitals. So in region two, they already have it since I think last month. But then in other regions, it's still being kept in the provincial office or in the LGUs.
Mm-mm. So one thing clear is Secretary Duque made a mistake in blaming the private hospitals.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think he was misinformed by his people that these are already disbursed to the private hospitals.
Oh, to the management of the hospitals. And you have checked that all the members of PHAP have no funds that are in their hospitals.
Once they have received it, they have nothing to do but disburse it to the healthcare workers, because that's not the money of the hospital, that's the money of the healthcare workers.
Mm-mm. And just for clarification, it's an opportunity to also educate everybody when it comes to the coverage of this particular law. It's number one, this does not discriminate between private and public medical frontliners, correct?
Yeah.
That's one. But within that, who is who can actually avail of it? For example, is it only those exposed to COVID patients, those assigned to COVID wards?
Yes. Actually, that was the more or less a discussion that was made during the hearing, no? Because some are saying that only those people, let's say the nurses who are in direct contact with the COVID patients should be given. But then some healthcare workers are saying that ay, lahat naman, yung hangin na inisingot nila dyan is the same. You know, if you're inside the hospital, we breathe the same air. Diba? We are exposed to the same virus. So why give it only to let's say, to the people who are really in direct contact? Even if we are not in really in direct contact, we still are exposed to the virus because we are working inside a hospital facility.
Mm-mm. That's it. But what is the coverage under the law?
Under the law, it's only 5,000 per month maximum. No,
for those only in the COVID wards and exposed to COVID patients.
Supposedly, it's covered for at least 22 days a month. So if you were on duty for 22 days, then you are covered for 5,000. Anybody who were on duty for 22 days should be covered by the 5,000.
Oo. Maganda kasi yung tanong ng isang union employee, what about the lab people, the other medical frontliners who may not be nurses?
They should be covered also because they interact with the patients. You know, lab people, they get laboratory exams. They even go directly to the patients. No, x-rays. X-ray people, they go there. And even, of course, nurses and nursing attendants, they go there. Even doctors, the attending physicians, they are in direct contact also with the, you know, even the orderly, the one cleaning the beds or the room, they are exposed also.
So I'm curious, for example, the hospital you're in, what hospital are you in, Dr. Degrano, in Batangas?
It's Lipamedics Medical Center.
Have an idea how many medical frontliners are actually qualified for the SRA Plus benefits?
I'm not really sure. We have around 400. We have around 400 employees.
Everybody I've interviewed, this seems to be a problem. Nobody seems to know the numbers, honestly. It seems that overall in the whole Philippines, whatever group I speak with, they don't have the total numbers. You know, wala bang data collection that PHAP can do so that each hospital already submits. So then you, for example, can ask a specific amount of money when you're interviewed.
There are requirements before you can be given. That you have to submit requirements like a schedule of duties. And then this will be examined by the Department of Health. They will check on it. Now, let's say...
is red tape. This is why the benefits take long.
Probably initially. But then, you know, the schedules, these things, these requirements are certified. Supposedly, they are certified by the head of the hospital, by the medical director, by the hospital administrator. That means that they are responsible for the truth or the certification on that document. So actually, they just have to check on whether we have signed the document. And then, of course, if they find out later that we're not saying the truth, then they can get back at the medical director and the chief of hospitals.
But do you also, coming from the side of the private hospitals, is there also data available? I mean, for example, in the hospital that you're in, do you also have the names already? Do you have the numbers? Do you have the amounts that you need?
Yes, that is a requirement. And so we submitted that. Mm-hmm. And they gave us actually an amount already. So the amount is based on what we submitted. And after checking, so they already have an amount. Let's say other hospitals also have an amount for their hospital. So that's it. We're just waiting for the after the approval, because I think it's already approved because it's already for disbursement. The problem is it passed through pa dun sa local government units at tumagal na naman yung processing. We don't know, yeah, that's bureaucracy in government.
Okay. All right. What do you make right now of the hearings in both the lower house and the Senate exposing the transfer of billions of pesos to the Department of Budget and Management and then overpriced procured medical supplies?
Well, that is the finding of the COA.
Your reaction
actually,
as a doctor?
Yun lang thing, right now. As a doctor, let's say like this, you know,
as the head of the
second tranche, the second tranche supposedly was 9.02 billion. That was what was approved by administrative order 42, and it was supposed to have been released June 16 of 2021. You know how much the Department of Health gave or disbursed? It's only 7.1 billion. So where is that?
Where is the
almost 2 billion? It was returned to DBM. Again, there was supposed to have given to our healthcare workers. Imagine that's almost 2 billion that was returned. That was yun ang sinasabi nila, di ba, sa mga allocations. Bakit may allocation ng ganitong pera na papabalik at hindi nagagamit? Ay, we have the money.
So what is the problem with the DOH? Is it mismanagement, inefficiency? Is it a lack of strategy? I'm curious what you think. I mean, clearly, do they need help in terms of management? I'm curious, can doctors run things? Because it boggles the mind, really. But eto, sir, I can hear you now.
That's the problem with...
What is the problem with the DOH?
Our line is unstable. I can...
Yeah. Dr. Rene de Grange's internet is not stable, but can you try again, sir?
Yeah.
Okay. Close closing statement. And what is the problem of the DOH? What are you seeing on the ground? Is there a problem?
Okay. I'm not sure if this is the right answer. You know, I think the problem here is, of course, the implementation of the different, maybe the different administrative orders, different circulars. Sometimes actually they conflict even with the different administrative orders or circulars of the PhilHealth. Imagine both entities are government entities, and they sometimes don't agree with all these orders and circulars. And we are really, we don't know what to do sometimes because hirapan kami. Right now, I think in the next coming days, meron naman bagong inilabas na circular ang PhilHealth. And that is, I think, medyo magkakaroon ng problem again ang mga private hospitals.
And let's talk about PhilHealth.
PhilHealth
also owes private hospitals something like 20 billion pesos. Have they at least paid a part of that already?
Actually, nag-meet kami, and their presentation showed it's not only 20, it is already around 86 billion. Doon sa 86 billion, alam mo, 26 billion owes the private hospital. We will, we will include everything, Meron silang RTH, the return to hospital amounting to around 46 billion. There is a portion of the denied claims amounting to more or less around, I think it's 13.8 billion. And then the in-process claims, it's amounting to around 25.5 6.6 billion. So in totality, it's around 86 billion pesos. And they actually presented it to us. Of course, they are saying that the RT8s and the denied claims are not being processed because they lack, let's say, requirements, etc., and they violated something like that. But still, if you will note, that's 86 billion that was not paid to the private or government hospitals by PhilHealth.
Okay, wait, I'm curious. 86 billion, so we are factual, hasn't been paid to private hospitals only or private and public hospitals?
They are saying that it's both private and public hospitals.
Okay, what about private hospitals? How much does PhilHealth owe?
In, I think it's around almost what they're saying is around 15 billion for private hospitals and the rest for the government hospitals of the 25 billion.
What is the effect in terms of the private hospital service with PhilHealth not paying? I mean, let's just round it off to 20 billion. Yes. Anong epekto nito sa mga pribadong ospital?
Yun. Remember that private hospitals rely mainly on our patients, on the services that we give our patients, on how much they pay the private hospitals. Unlike the government facilities, they can withstand this, you know, because they have budget. They are subsidized by government, by the taxes paid by the people. But pag ang mga private hospitals, if a big portion of that is the payment of the PhilHealth to us, at hindi dumating yan, medyo mapipilay yung operations ng mga private hospitals. Remember, we also get there our payroll, our medications that we give to the patients. And remember, pagka meron kang, this is just an example for a COVID patient. No? If you get a moderately infected COVID patient, yeah, the benefits nga is around 143,000. Mm-hmm. So if you get 10 patients, that would be around 1.4 million in 2 weeks' time, and then siguro 2.8 million in a month's time. And this is being advanced by the private hospitals. And we are waiting for the payment or the reimbursement after how many months? 4 months? 6 months? That will not be, we will not be able to survive if every time these payments are being held by PhilHealth.
All right. Mm-hmm. On that note, Dr. Rene De Grano, thank you so much for joining me this morning. I appreciate it, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Tavian.